Are you tired of spending endless hours manually labeling your data for your machine learning projects? And let's face it, obtaining labeled training data can be time-consuming and expensive. In this video, I'll introduce you a game-changing tool called Snorkel to help you quickly label your data. Let's dive right in. So what is Snorkel? Snorkel is an open-source Python library for programmatically building training datasets in just hours or days, saving you time and improving the quality of your training data. To install Snorkel, type pip install Snorkel. The code and article for this video can be found in the description of this video. We will use Snorkel on the dataset Real Fake Job Posting Prediction from Kaggle. To make the code easier to work with, I pre-processed the data and split it into train and test set. Let's see what the training dataset looks like. This dataset contains the features related to a job description, such as title, location, company profile, description, requirements, and so on. The fraudulent column is a label that denotes whether a job posting is fake or not. Let's create labeling functions based on our assumptions about a fake company. Firstly, we assume that fake companies don't have company profiles or logos. Secondly, we assume that real companies require a background check. Lastly, we assume that real companies require a certain level of experience or education. Let's test those assumptions using Snorkel's labeling function decorator. Before using this decorator, we will make the code more readable by assigning 1 to fake, 0 to real, and -1 to abstain, indicating the prediction is inconclusive. Next, let's create functions to label the data using the labeling function decorator. We can see that each function decides whether a sample is fake, real, or abstain based on some conditions. These functions are the implementations of all the assumptions I mentioned previously. We will use these labeling functions to label our training dataset. We will put all of them in a list and pass that list as an argument to the pandas LF applier object. Next, we will call the apply method to apply all of the labeling functions to the training and test dataset. Now that we have created the labels, how do we determine the accuracy of these labels? That could be quickly done with the LF analysis object. We will use LF analysis to compare the actual labels with the labels generated by the labeling functions. After running the code, we will have this table. This table shows the detailed statistics of all labeling functions. Let's take a look at each of these statistics. Polarity is a set of unique labels this labeling function outputs, excluding -1. Coverage is a fraction of the dataset that is labeled. Overlaps is a fraction of the dataset where this labeling function and at least one other labeling function agree. Conflicts is a fraction of the dataset where this labeling function and at least one other labeling function disagree. Correct is a number of data points this labeling function labels correctly. Incorrect is a number of data points this labeling function labels incorrectly. And empirical accuracy is the accuracy of this labeling function calculated by this formula. From the table, we can see that the accuracy of the labeling functions has background check, require experience, and require education are above 0.95. Without testing, we would not guess these features as a strong indicator of fake job posting. If you found this video helpful, please take a moment to click the like button below. This will only take you 1 second, but it will help me to spread this video to more people and encourage me to continue creating high quality content like this. Now, let's get back to the video. Snorkel is also a great tool for evaluating labeling functions when you don't have true labels available. To evaluate labeling functions without true labels, you can simply leave the while argument unspecified. We can see that there are some conflicts between labeling functions. This could mean that a labeling function predicts that a job posting is fake, while another predicts that a job posting is real. Let's see if there is any conflict between the no company logo labeling function and the required experience labeling function. First, we use getLabelBuckets to get data point indices organized by label combinations. This method takes into two arrays of predictions. The first array contains predictions generated by no company logo labeling function, while the second array contains predictions generated by the required experience labeling function. Next, we will get the bucket with conflicting label combinations. Randomly select 10 samples from that bucket and display only these three columns. Let's see how the result looks like. The table shows that many companies require specific experience but has no company logo. This causes a difference in predictions between two labeling functions. So what should you do in these cases? One straightforward way is to use a majority vote. To understand how this method works, let's start with an example. If there are two ones and one zero, then the prediction will be one. Negative one is ignored if there are no ties. If there are ties, then negative one is returned. It is as simple as that. Let's try out this labeling model and see how it performs on the test set. First, we will get the real labels for the training and test sets. Then use the majority label voter to combine predictions from different labeling functions. Lastly, we use the score method to evaluate the final predictions. We got an accuracy of 80.7%, which is pretty good. That's it. I hope this video will motivate you to automate your labeling process and save weeks or even months of manual labor. After creating a training data set, you might want to version your data and store it in a secure, reliable storage service. In this next video, I will show you how to do exactly that with DVC, a powerful data version control tool designed specifically for machine learning projects. Thanks for listening.